Wish at this time to declare their marriage partnership to the world. It is a statement of commitment and to the ideals they already have. A happy marriage, they know, will enable them to establish a home where there is love and stability, where you, the family and friends, will find welcome, peace and support. Can you smile, please? My name is Kay McGrath and I'm a registered marriage celebrant, and I feel privileged to officiate this wonderful event here today. I am duly authorised to solemnise marriages by law. Daniel Michael Deva and Carlee Ann Glendinning, before you are joined in marriage in my presence and the presence of these witnesses, I am to remind you of the solemn and binding nature of the relationship you are about to enter. Marriage, according to law in Australia, is a union of a man and a woman, to the exclusion of all others, voluntarily entered into for life. You're still shaking? Family, friends, at this time, on behalf of Daniel and Carlee, I would like to acknowledge these important people in their life. Daniel and Carlee believe they have been taught their values, been shown how to laugh, love, and appreciate all that life has to offer. Their generosity, support, and love is unending. Can I please ask Michael and Layla and John and Vicky to please come forward, please? Now, I'd like everyone to turn around. Don't hit him now. I would like everyone, please, to officially welcome their parents here tonight. Daniel, do take Carlee to be your best friend and lover, asking that she be no other than herself, sharing her pain and joy, and respecting her beliefs and ideals, and accepting her differences for all the years to come.
I do.
Do Carlee take Daniel to be your best friend and lover, asking that he be no other than himself, sharing his pain and joy, and respecting his beliefs and ideals, and accepting his differences for all the years to come.
I do.
Family, friends, we're now up to the vows. These words are very important. This forms part of the legal wording within the ceremony. Daniel, would you repeat after me, please?
I call upon.
Everyone here present.
To witness that I, Daniel Devers.
Take you, Carlee Glendinning.
To be my wedded wife.
Carlee, I want to be with you.
Always just as you are.
I choose you.
Above all others.
To share my life.
With me in marriage.
I love you for yourself.
And I want you to become.
All that you can be.
I promise to honour this pledge.
As long as I shall live.
Good on you, mate. Yeah.
Carlee, it's your turn. You ready?
Carlee, would you repeat after me, please?
I call upon.
Everyone here present. To witness that I, Carlee Glendinning. Take you, Daniel Devers. To be my wedded husband. Daniel, I want to be with you. Always just as you are.
I choose you.
Above all others.
To share my life.
With me in marriage. I love you for yourself. And I want you to become. All that you can be. I promise to honour this pledge. As long as I shall live.
Can I have the vows, please? Someone promised me they'd have them. Daniel, as you put this ring on Carlee's ring finger, would you repeat after me?
Carlee, I'll give you this ring.
As a symbol of. All that we share. It is my personal gift to you. That you are my wife. As long as I live.
And you can just push it on. Does it fit?
Yeah.
Carlee, as you put this ring on Daniel's ring finger, will you repeat after me, please?
Daniel, I give you this ring. As a symbol of. All that we share. This is my personal gift to you. That you are my husband. As long as I live.
And you can just push it on. went better than the reverse. Ladies and gentlemen, Daniel and Carlee have declared before all of us that they'll live together in... You can hold hands, you know. They have declared before all of us that they'll live together in marriage. They have made special promises to each other in the context of their own special ceremony. In a traditional way, they have symbolised it by joining hands, taking vows and exchanging rings. Therefore, I have much pleasure in declaring you to be husband and wife. Daniel and Christopher. Well done, you have been practicing. We'll only be a few moments while we sign the register and we will return.
Enslaved.
Everybody, I'm sure you all agree that Daniel and Carlee chose a lovely ceremony. Now would everyone please welcome Mr. and Mrs. Daniel and Carlee Davis. Can I ask the parents please come forward and officially congratulate the couple, and then please everyone else can join in afterwards.
Lovely job.
Hello, thank you everyone for coming. This good surprise, I'm so proud of these guys. But actually don't really like Daniel, even though he's my hetero life partner. So, I got my other mate to do it. Take it away, Maddie.
Thanks, Steve-O. Hi, I'm Matthew Lloyd, the former Essendon captain. When Steve-O told me Carlee and Daniel were getting married, I asked if I could do it. He asked me to do a speech. I asked why a speech, and he told me because he doesn't really like Daniel and couldn't be bothered writing one himself. I thought to myself, that makes sense. So congratulations to Daniel and Carlee. Thank you, everyone, for coming. I hope you enjoy this surprise. I'd like to start by saying that Lockie is the luckiest little man to have the nicest two people in the world as his parents. Paul, Darren, Brad and Steve-O, have told me how they can see, as I'm sure everyone else can, how proud Daniel and Carlee are of Lockie every time they talk about him. From Lockie drinking his bottle for the first time on his own, just like Dad drinking his frothies, to following, just like Dad does after a lot of frothies, to getting his second tooth, which is one more than his own dad. The boys informed me that as soon as Lockie can walk on his own, the little man is officially smarter than his dad. Steve-O also told me he's super proud of Carlee and Daniel, but he would be even more proud of Carlee if she could Google the word haircut and put Daniel in. That would be appreciated. Enough is enough. He's not a 17-year-old skateboarder anymore. The rugged Steve-O has had the same haircut since he was 23, but he didn't have a choice. Daniel, you do. Who would have thought that Daniel, a mediocre skateboarder, and Steve-O, a professional rollerblader, could be besties? Not to mention Daniel barracks for us, the Mighty Bombers, and Steve-O, the calm loser. Both of them are like snowboarding, hey? I'll never forget the story the boys told me about that time at Mount Buller, when Daniel hit the smallest tree ever and smashed his knee into pieces. That was the day everyone realised your dream of playing for Essendon was over. Hang on, they realised that back at under 10s. You were no good. For someone with half a kneecap, why is your kneecap four times bigger than it should be? I've heard it's absolutely disgusting. Next time when you crash and the doctor asks you if you've had any alcohol, say no next time. I know you guys will never break the tradition of a Jager bomb as soon as you get to the top of the mountain, but trust me, you're going to need your income protection next time. You thought 3 months with no money sucked while you recovered, but guess what? You are married now and have a kid, and one of them loves expensive handbags. I'm in the market for a boat, and Carlee told me you have one for sale, going very cheap. Speaking of Carlee, we may have lost Carlee Glendenning, but we gained Carlee Devers. How many Devers do we actually need? As Steve, I was always told Daniel, he would be willing to make an honest woman out of Elish and welcome her into the whole family. Daniel, you and Steven have been mates for almost 30 years. You guys have had each other's backs and have had so many laughs. He wants you to know that he'll have your back for at least another 30 years. I can see that the next 30 years will be even better and funnier than the first 30 for you two. Finally, I would like to wish Daniel and Carlee an awesome life together, and everyone can't wait for you guys to get a couple more of more members for your little footy team. Then maybe Carlee can have a chance to get one to follow North Melbourne.
Yeah!
Thanks for allowing me to say a few words. Thank you, and enjoy the rest of your night.
Thank you very much. Drink up.
John, Dan.
Faint!
Why don't you say something?
I'm a man of few words. Thank you.
He's just like his father-in-law.
Hey, how are you?
He's just like his father-in-law.
Just want to thank everyone who's here. Like, we're praying everyone would come because we didn't want you to miss out. You know, Shay, I felt terrible lying to you.
But you did it.
We lied to many people.
About 3 months straight.
Okay.
But yeah, thank you everyone for coming. Thanks.
Yeah, thanks guys. Yeah. We really appreciate it.
Thank you. Open bar!
Okay, let's invite the bridal couple over to the table to cut the cake.